Hi everyone! This video is going to be about MQTT. To start, MQTT is a lightweight messaging protocol that is widely used in IoT topologies by a lot of client devices like smart home meters or even drones. Why? Primarily because it is positioned as a bandwidth-efficient protocol which can help result in reduced bandwidth costs. A typical MQTT topology consists of three roles: a broker or the server where the data is stored, a publisher, a device that sends the data to a specific topic, and a subscriber to the topic, a device that listens and awaits for the data to be published. For a production environment, we advise you to use MQTT with certificates to establish a secure SSL MQTT communication. RouterOS is now able to be the broker, the publisher, and the subscriber. MQTT publish and subscribe features are available for all architectures that have IoT package available for download. And with container feature, your ARM32-bit, ARM64-bit and CHR devices on version 7 can now run, for example, a local Mosquito MQTT broker. To help you with the installation, visit our Mosquito container guide by following the link in the description. There are also publicly available MQTT servers like AWS or Azure, so feel free to use them instead. Once you have the server up and running, we can test MQTT publishing and subscribing. You can run different MQTT roles on a single board, but we will separate them. In our setup, the Mosquito broker is run on a CHR, and the subscriber and the publisher are going to be CNAs. Starting with the subscriber, add a new broker, name it, select username, client ID, and broker's IP address. Allowed usernames, passwords, and client IDs are defined by the server settings. Subscribe to the created broker by choosing a topic where the data is expected to be published. Connect to the broker. The subscriber is ready, subscribed and connected. All that's left is the publisher. In its settings, also add the broker the exact same way, but preferably use another username and ID. Connect to it. It's time to send the message. Specify which broker to use, under which topic to send the message, and the message itself. The last step is to check received messages back on the subscriber. To confirm the reception, issue the command that is shown on the screen. Simple as that, this should give you a general idea on how MQTT operates. With this functionality, you can structure and publish your own MQTT messages that contain information about the RouterOS system, its uptime, memory and CPU usage, and so much more. Script example is shown in the written guide, so check it out. We could end the video here, but I would like to quickly mention a new MQTT feature, the onMessage feature. This feature allows you to set up a script, and it will be run every time a new MQTT message appears under the subscribe topic, which can help you automate stuff. The script can contain a command to change a setting, disable a specific interface, maybe enable an additional firewall rule, reboot the device, or a command to do something else entirely, it's only up to you. To put it in motion, add an onMessage configuration with a script of your choice to the subscription like shown on the screen. This is a very basic example with a very basic logging script that just creates a log entry whenever a new message is received. And then just publish the test message and check the result. Success! Logging script was triggered. I hope this video was informative, and if you did like the content, please subscribe. Thank you for watching.